Today we are going to study the modulus of complex number and its property. In the last class, we made a long discussion on idea of complex number and organ play. So guys, today we start this class with an important fact from complex number point of view. So let's have a look on this property. Root A into root B, this is equal to root AB. This is valid only if at least one of either A or B is non-negative. Non-negative, then this holds good. Otherwise, it is invalid. So let us consider an example. Root 1 whole square, this can be written as root 1 into root over of minus 1. And the left hand side, this is equal to minus 1. And right hand side, if we don't follow this rule, that is minus 1 and root over minus 1, then instead of this, we can write root over of minus 1 into minus 1. So violating the rule of this, then this is equal to positive quantity and this is equal to 1. So minus 1 is equal to 1 and 0 is equal to 2. So this is the absurd result.
Now we talk about the modulus of complex number. What does it mean?
Actually, if you consider a point P on organ plane, P is equal to J plus XY, it is considered. And what does mean it? X means this is the distance. If you draw a perpendicular line from P, then the distance OA means X. This is the real part of complex number. And the PA is the imaginary part of complex number. Then it forms a right angle triangle. That is OAP, this is a right angle triangle. And from the Pythagoras theorem, we know the hypotenuse square equal to base square plus perpendicular square. From this result, we can write the distance OP. OP is equal to root over of x square plus y square. And normally, it is denoted by OP. OP means the distance of a point from the origin. And this OP, this is denoted by modulus of Z. And this is known as modulus Z. Or you can write mod of Z, whatever you like. And now we learn about some properties related to modulus. So first of all, see here, Z is equal to X plus IY. So just we have learned mod of Z is equal to X square plus Y square. So we made a discussion on conjugate, complex conjugate in the last class. You know, Z bar, this is equal to X minus IY. So if you want to find the modulus of Z bar, then definitely it will be X square plus Y square. So we can write modulus of Z is equal to modulus of Z bar. This is the property number one. Comes to the second point. Point two. Z bar, this is equal to modulus of Z whole square. So how can you derive this? Z is equal to X plus IY and X minus IY instead of Z bar. So if you follow the product rule of complex number, then you can write X square plus Y square. It means root over of X square plus Y square whole square. That is, we can replace this. That is, Z bar is equal to modulus of Z whole square. It's an important property. In similar way, we can prove the property 3, 4 and 5. Now comes to the property 6. 6. Z1 minus Z2. It means X1, first of all we consider Z1 is equal to X1 plus IY1. And Z2 is equal to X2 plus IY2. That is X1 minus X2 plus I into Y1 Y2. This modulus of Z1 minus Z2, it means X1 minus X2 whole square plus Y1 minus Y2 whole square. If you take the modulus of two complex number, that will be equal to this. What does mean it? This is the distance between two points, Z1 and Z2 on a organ plane. That is, For a clear idea, if draw, this is the real axis, this is the imaginary axis, and consider two points, suppose z1 and z2. This is equal to x1 plus iy1 and this is equal to x2 plus iy2. That is, this is the distance between them. So, whenever we take modulus of z1 minus z2, it means this is the distance between two complex points on our plane. If two points z1 and z2 are given on an organ plane, then you have to know what is the position, what is the location of the point z1 plus z2. So you always remember, if you complete a parallelogram considering this, OA and OB are two adjacent sides of parallelogram, then the opposite vertex of the origin, it represents the, suppose this is the C. C represents the position of Z1 plus Z2. Have a look on this result. 7, 8 and 9. These are the inequalities related to complex number. So comes to the rule 7. So before that, just look here. This is a triangle. And you know the triangle rule, the sum of two sides must be greater than of the largest side, BC. So from this we can write OB plus BC, this must be greater than equal to OC. That is, what does mean it? OB means modulus of Z2. BC, this is the equivalent of OA. OA equal to BC because it's a parallelogram. So modulus of Z1 represents the length of BC. This must be greater than equal to modulus of OC, that is Z1 plus Z2 whole modulus. So this is the important rule, or you can write Z1 plus Z2 modulus less than equal to Z1 plus Z2. Now see the result 8. So before deriving the result 8, we must draw a diagram. Just see here, minus z2 is a complex point, which is the image point of z2 with respect to the origin. Because if you consider z2 is equal to x2 plus iy2, then minus z2 will be minus x2 minus iy2. So this lies on the fourth quadrant. So this is the image point with respect to the origin. Now, if we want to make a diagram, the representation of z1 plus minus z2, it represents, if you complete the parallelogram considering this side and this side, the two adjacent sides of parallelogram, then in a similar way we can conclude that the position of z1 minus z2 is equal to this. In this way we can form it. Now we form a triangle OB.C. Just I have written here. From this, with the help of triangle inequality, we can write, that is OB. Plus B.C. This is greater than equal to OC. So OC. Means Z1 minus Z2 modulus. This less than equal to OB, that is modulus of Z2, and this is modulus of Z1 because this is the opposite side of parallelogram OA, that is Z1 plus Z2. So this is the important inequality of complex number. Come to the property 9. This property, this is a very important property. So let us prove this. Modulus of Z1, instead of this, we can write modulus of Z1 minus Z2 plus Z2, because if you erase bracket, Z2 will be cancelled. And using the property, this property, property 7, we can write modulus because this is the complex number and this is also complex number. That is modulus of Z1 minus Z2 plus Z1 plus Z2. So this sounds good. So instead of this, modulus of Z1 minus modulus of Z2, this less than equal to modulus of Z1 minus Z2, or this equal to this. Now consider modulus of Z2. Instead of this, we can write this, because Z1 will be cancelled and Z will be remaining. And this less than equal to modulus of Z1 minus Z2 plus Z1. So from this, we can have result this. Just see carefully, modulus of Z1 minus Z2 greater than equal to this. Z1 modulus of Z1 minus modulus of Z2. Again, similar thing, minus modulus of minus Z1 minus Z2 modulus, this greater than equal to Z2 modulus minus Z1 modulus. Here Z1 modulus minus modulus Z2. Here Z2 modulus minus modulus Z1. So combining these two results, this result and this result, we can conclude the inequality. This is a very important property. So as far as JEE main and advanced is concerned, these three properties very important. Here we solve two important problems, and particularly for joint entrance examination. First of all, one, if this modulus of this complex number equal to 1, then find Z2 is equal to 4, and it is also given Z1 not equal to B. So we are solving here. First of all, consider this property, modulus of Z whole square is equal to Z bar, and this is the important property. So application of this problem, actually application of this property. Now squaring both sides, so just follow the rule. Squaring means modulus of Z whole square, modulus of this quantity whole square, this is equal to this whole conjugate of this equal to 1. And with the help of the properties of the conjugate, we can write this step, and after some steps we will have this result, this one. And again, we have been able to make this quantity, this expression, into the product of two factors, and it is given Z1 not equal to B. Then if it holds good, then modulus of Z2 square is equal to A square, or modulus of Z2 is equal to A. So answer will be modulus of Z2 is equal to A. This is a very important problem. Now we solve the second problem. What is given there? If a complex number satisfies the equation modulus of Z plus 4i equal to 3, then find the greatest and least value of modulus of Z plus 3. So how to solve this? So first of all, write Z plus 3 modulus, and just it's a matter of adjustment. Just you erase the bracket, then 4i will be cancelled and Z plus 3 will be there. So instead of this, we can write this quantity, this expression. Now just following the rule 7, just we have derived this less than equal to modulus of this plus modulus of this. We have it is given that modulus of Z plus 4i, that is modulus of Z plus 4i equal to 3. So we are writing here 3, and you know the modulus of Z plus 3 minus 4i, it's a 5. So this is less than equal to 8. So greatest value of modulus of Z plus 3 equal to 8. Just we have got it. Now comes to the least value of this modulus of Z plus 3. Now this is the matter of adjustment. Just instead of Z plus 3, we are writing here 4i will be cancelled and Z plus 3 will be there. Then just the last rule of the modulus property, the inequality, you can say this is less than greater than equal to modulus of this minus modulus of this. And the last result of the property of modulus, that is result 9, then this is given, this is equal to 3 and this is the 5, and 3 minus 5 means minus 2. So modulus value of minus 2 is equal to 2. So just we have got the modulus of Z plus 3 less than equal to 8 and greater than equal to 2. So this is the largest value and this is the least value. Okay guys, three important problems are given for home tasks. Try to solve these and verify the answers given.
Okay guys, in the next class we will have detailed discussion on argument of complex number and its properties. So keep watching.